I place before you the book of life at St. James, where the names of those who have preceded us in death are inscribed. You'll understand why in just a moment.
Ballistic missile threat inbound to Hawaii. Seek immediate shelter. This is not a drill.
Cell phone signals here were absolutely overloaded as people called their loved ones to say goodbye, as others ran for cover. It was a chaotic and confusing scene and a place known for its tranquility.
Can you imagine how they felt? Hawaii, a series of islands. Just a week ago, 8 days ago, on their devices, their smartphones, their iPhones, any device that can receive a text message, they received that warning. Emergency alert. Ballistic missile inbound to Hawaii. Take immediate cover. This is not a test. Happened 2 days later in Japan, another island nation. Where do you go? What do you do? They thought they were going to die, because wherever they went to take shelter with a nuclear attack, there is no shelter. Now, let me explain how this works. I know this because I worked as a consultant with Samsung for 2 years while with a worldwide agency. This is a Galaxy device. We helped launch the device. Governments all over the world require the Samsungs, the Apples, the LGs, the manufacturers of these devices to do the following. They must allow these devices to be broadcast for emergency alert. And the way the technology works is, even if the devices are turned off, as long as there's battery life, if an emergency alert goes out, the devices come on, there is a message, exactly like the one you just heard, and a tone. How many of you here have a device that will receive a text message? Raise your hands, please. The overwhelming majority of us. Imagine then, at this moment, we heard the following. Emergency alert. Inbound ballistic missile to Milwaukee. Take immediate cover. This is not a test. Wow. Now, as upsetting as this is, we don't like to think about these things, but perhaps, in fact, there is surely good in this kind of thing, and here's why. It's good for us, young, middle-aged, and old, to come to grips, to face head-on the fact that our names are going to be inscribed in this book of life someday, or whatever parish that you're at. And so then, we should be all of the time thinking about what it is we should be doing with our lives that we may not currently be doing, so we are ready for that final passage from life on earth to life in eternal salvation. And so we have ordinary time. We're only in the second Sunday. I know it says the third, but it's actually the second. Talk to me after Mass, and I'll tell you how that works. And in ordinary time, this short period between Christmas and Lent, and then again a much longer period from the end of the Easter season to Advent, ordinary time is for the disciples. It's for us. It's for us to get grips on what it is we should be doing in our lives. So what did the ordinary time readings say to us today? It's rare that all three have identical theme. Did you hear in these three readings the following from Jonah? 40 days more and Nineveh shall be destroyed. 40 days more and Sussex shall be destroyed. From Paul to the Corinthians, I tell you, brothers and sisters, time is running out. From Christ himself in the gospel, this is the time of fulfillment. The kingdom of God is at hand. So here is what I think our forefathers and foremothers are saying to us. Seize this instant. Live life to its fullest. God came that we might have life through Christ, and that we might have life in abundance, not death, but life. So seize every moment like it's your last one. Put another way, carpe diem.
Gather ye rosebuds while ye may, old time is still a-flying, and this same flower that smiles today, tomorrow will be dying.
Thank you, Mr. Pitts. Gather ye rosebuds while ye may. The Latin term for that sentiment is carpe diem. Now, who knows what that means?
Carpe diem. That's seize the day.
Seize the day. Gather ye rosebuds while ye may. Why does the writer use these lines? Because believe it or not, each and every one of us in this room is one day going to stop breathing, turn cold, and die. I'd like you to step forward over here and peruse some of the faces from the past.
He's asking his students to come and look at pictures of students who have gone before them.
They're not that different from you, are they? Same haircuts, invincible, just like you feel. The world is their oyster. They believe they're destined for great things, just like many of you. Their eyes are full of hope. Just like you. Did they wait until it was too late to make from their lives even one iota of what they were capable? But if you listen real close, you can hear them whisper their legacy to you. Go on, lean in. Listen. You hear it?
Make your lives extraordinary at this moment, at this day. The time of fulfillment is at hand. It's what God is calling us to do through Scripture. My sisters and brothers, I'm going to sit down now and be silent. Don't applaud. That's okay. And in that time of silence, I ask you to lean in and listen to those who have gone before us. Listen to their whisper and what they're calling us to pay attention to today. Emergency alert. Time is running out. Take action. This is not a test. For the good of God, make your lives extraordinary.